this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how you can draw any shape in After Effects. And after that, we'll rig it and then animate it. I'm starting by creating a composition. I'm calling it Can. White 1080, height 9020. And for frame 30. And duration 6 seconds. I downloaded the reference that I chose to draw. I'm putting it in my composition. I scale it and lock it. I start from the top to the bottom. I use the ellipse to draw a smooth circle. I turn off fill and stroke. Maximize panel by pressing this key. And I click and hold until the reference size. I move the path by holding the space key. I need to place the path exactly in the center of reference stroke. And the same for the next one. So I want to draw this part. I use the pen tool for this part. I put the first point exactly on this part. Just click and release to be linear. Now I click and hold until it be busier. To lock it in the horizontal axis, I hold down shift key. And I fix it. And I click and release the next one. And the same for this one. And for here, click and hold to be easier. And I close it. Now I wanna draw the parts of the door. First, I click here and drag. I use this handle for adjust the path. So that I can draw the next point separately, I hold the command and click on the screen. And now I can create a new shape. And the same here. I'm using the ellipse tool for this circle. And I click and drag. Now I want to name the shape that I made. I click on the layer and press return to rename it Can. These first three shapes are related to the door. I select them and right click on them to group shape. I press return on the shape and rename it door. This shape is related to the front. I call it face. The inner circle inside. And for this outside. I select all the shape and right click on them and select group shape. And I press return on the shape and name it top. This will be the top of the can. And I solo it. I want to add a stroke to them. I select the can and I click the stroke and use the color black. And I set the thickness to 6. I compare it with my reference. This circle is too much. I select the ellipse to reduce its thickness. And I change it to 3. Now it's okay. Now I want to add fill to them. I hide it and select it. From above, door is not needed. For face, I select on the fill and pick the eyedropper and choose the color from here. Same for the inside. This is the highlight. I pick the color from this part. And the same for outside. I think this part is good. And I look at my shape and it's okay. Only one thing remains. If you look at here, the thickness of this part is less than here. If I wanted to do this in After Effects, it looks like this. I'm going this way and I open this part. And I open in stroke and open the wave part. And for the unit, I change it from pixel to circle. And I change the value of the circle to 1. And I raise the amount to the 30. We made something like this. Now I can copy the wave and add it to the part of the door. I select on the stroke and paste it. Now I hide this layer and start drawing the body. I choose the pen tool and I select on the layer. I create the first point up here to behind the top. A little bezier for here. I hold down shift and when I click, it will be right below the previous vector. I'm pulling it up to the middle of the curve. And the same for here. And I hold the shift for this part. And I close it here. I can bring this part down so it doesn't get mixed up with the above path. To bezier it, I hold Option key and drag. I select the fill and I pick up the eyedropper. And I choose the color here and for a stroke I set it to 10. Let's see what's happened. I call this layer body. And I put it lower than the top and we have this. Now I wanna draw this part. I select the shape and hide it. And I start drawing with the pen. This happened when I put the pen close to the path, which is something we don't want. Instead, I can make my point a little further away and then move it. I turn off the fill and stroke thickness is 10. And let's see what's happened. So that I can cut the line into pieces like a reference, I give them dashes. I call this shape ring. I open it and I open its stroke and I click on its dashes. This is how it goes. I increase the dashes to 150. And I click on the plus again to add gap and I increase the gap amount to 60. And to round the edges of the line, I change the butt cap to round cap. And to make the middle figure, I use wave. And I go to the wave part and I change the pixel to circle. And I set the circle value to 2 because it's more than one line. And I increase the mouth to 40. And to make this part wider than the rest, I can replace it with phase. I increase the phase as much as I want. This is how it happened. Okay, now we are going to draw the bottom of the can. I start with the first point here. And I close the path. I click on fill, I pick the eyedropper, and I get the color from here. And the stroke thickness is too high. It should be 6. I turn it on and I put it name bottom. And I bring it all down. Now I want to add shadow and highlight to it. I select on shape and hide it. I start from here. I hold down shift and then click. I hold the option key to be able to change the line direction. And for here, like this. And I close it. Let's adjust it. I select these two shapes and I right click and group shape. And I call it HL. And now for the shadow, I start from here. I'll hold the shift key. And I take it a little further here, then I fix it. And I close it. And the same for this part. I hold the option key and change direction. And this part of the shadow is like this. And I select this shape and group them. I rename it shadow. Now I have to place them in body. I open the body and place these two shapes between the stroke and fill. And I turn it on and slow it. I select on the shadow, I turn off its stroke. I make color fill black for shadow. I turn off the stroke and I set white for highlights. Now they need to reduce the opacity. First, I reduce the opacity of the HL on its transform. And I put the value 25 for opacity. And for the shadow, set the main transform to 30. And I need to reduce the opacity of this shape as well. I set the transform of this shape and I set the opacity to 50. And this is how it's happened. And I compare it with the reference. Now I create the top highlights. I'll do it with the pen tool like before. and I close it. I will name the shape that was created HL. And I put it in the top under the door. I turn on the can and I set the opacity to 25. Now it's the logo turn. I got the Coca Cola logo from Wiki. I put it in my composition. I press the R key to rotate it 90 degrees. And I reduce its size by hit the S key. And I adjust it. And to be able to change its color, I use the fill effect. And I set the color to white. I put the logo up. And I draw the shadow of the can with the ellipse. I turn off fill and stroke. Because the light source is from this side, I'm putting the shadow this way. And I call it shadow. I take it down to the can. I change the fill color to black. And I press T key to set the opacity to 50. To soften the edges, I use the fast box blur effect. I put it on the shadow and I set it to 3. And we have this.